Okay, today I want to show you the male flower and female flower petiola, rose gold. Petiola, you can see all are male flower. So this male flower is always without ovary. So all these are male flower. You can see all flower inside there the stigma. Sorry, for male flower there is the anther. This is the male flower, you can see. So inside this is the anther. There are anther actually separated. So there have, with the anther they have so many pollen. So when I touching my finger, yes, there you can see the yellowish color. All these are pollen. Okay, now I want to show you the female flower here. You can see this one is okay. Sorry, difficult to show by one hand. So this one is the female. Female is always with the ovary. Okay, so this is the female flower with the ovary, and inside there is the stigma here. This one is the stigma. So the stigma is always sticky. So we have to bring the male flower to pollinate. Usually they have so many insect, honeybee, and so many others. They usually help in the pollination. But if you want to better, because they are monoecious, so they need help for the pollination from by means. There are so many ants also here. So I am trying to show you how to do the pollination. So I have plucked the male flower. You can see here. So this is the male flower. So you have to just toss on the stigma of the female flower. So this is the this is the pollination. So slowly with the pollen you have to toss on the stigma. So this is the pollination. So I'm doing by one hand, so very difficult to do the pollination. So this is the open pollination. So if you want to do the cross pollination, then you have to bag the female flower before opening. So this female flower you have to bag. Okay, so this female flower you have to bag first before opening. So when they open, so on the before you have to bag, then when they open, then you have to collect the so many male flower here, you can see. So all this male flower you have to bring, and you have to pollinate, and you have to bag again for the, then after 2 to 3 days you can see if the ovary is still alive and green color and is still growing, meaning is that your pollination is successful, that is fertilized, already fertilized, the successful fertilization. Then we can put hope that this will grow a healthy fruit. But in case of most of the cucurbitaceous scrub, the biggest enemy is the fruit fly. So you can see most of the fruit I have tried to covered by plastic bag. So you can see here is a small fruit here. See inside the plastic bag, because otherwise it will be bored. They usually bore inside the fruit and they damage. So here also have a small fruit inside, you can see. So I have packed inside. So you can see this is the fruit fly, or the one is flying here. So very difficult to control. So if you're not serious, so you will not harvest any fruit. You can see there are so many fruits here, so all are rotten. You can see this one I couldn't harvest. So all these fruits have been damaged by fruit fly. So it's the major enemy, and we can say this is only one enemy. So we have to protect properly by covering with plastic or any other waterproof paper for the successful harvesting of the fruit.